Question is, how we manage the change in the time while traveling around the world? Who tells us when to change the ship's time, and how does the change in time affect us? Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to Captain Zahid. In today's video, I will explain how we manage the different time zones, how and when we change the ship's time, and how we synchronize our watches with the ports. First of all, there are at least five times of interest that we need to talk about. They are called GMT or Greenwich Mean Time, ZT or Zone Time, LT or Local Time, SMT or Ship's Mean Time, and ST or the Standard Time. Another fun fact is that the time is independent of latitude. It does not really matter how high or how north or south of the equator you are. The time is dependent upon the longitude. Our Earth is divided into 360 divisions, just as a circle would. The only difference is that this 360 degrees of division is further divided into 180 degrees east and 180 degrees west. We call them the east longitudes and the west longitudes. The reference point here is the Greenwich Observatory in UK. The longitude passing through the Greenwich Observatory is referenced as 0 degrees longitude. This meridian line is also called as the prime meridian, and the longitude east of this meridian are referenced as the eastern longitudes, and the longitudes west of this meridian are referenced as, you guessed it right, west longitudes. And the time that is kept here at the Greenwich Observatory is known as the GMT or the Greenwich Mean Time. Our clocks in the whole world are based on this division of longitudes. There are 360 divisions of the world and 24 hours in a day. And if we divide 360 degrees by 24 hours, then the answer would be 15. That means for every 15 degrees of change in longitude, the clocks would change by 1 hour. For making this division easy, from 7.5 degrees west of the Greenwich to 7.5 degrees east of the Greenwich, the time zone is zero. For every 15 degrees of change in the longitude thereafter, 1 hour is either added or subtracted. This 1 hour zone is called as the time zone. To find out your time zone, you need to know the longitude, your longitude. For example, let's take the longitude of Islamabad. Islamabad is located at 33.68 degrees north and 073.04 degrees east. Now add 7.5 degrees to this to compensate for the GMT, and the answer is going to be 80.5 degrees. Now, we already know that every 15 degrees of longitude makes 1 hour. So now divide 80.5 degrees by 15 degrees and your answer will be 5.36. Ignore anything that's in points and your answer will be 5. This is how we know that Islamabad time zone would be GMT plus 5. This is called as zone time or ZT. Now, to understand the LT or local time, simply take your own longitude and divide it by 15. The answer will be your local time. For example, let's consider Islamabad again. If we divide Islamabad's longitude, that is 073.04, by 15, then the answer will be 4.86 hours or 4 hours and 52 minutes. This is called as LT or the local time. If you add Greenwich time to it, that is if you add 7.5 degrees to this longitude, then your answer would be 80.54 degrees or 5.369 hours or 5 hours and 22 minutes. Now, this time would be called as LMT or the local mean time. Now, let's understand the standard time. This is different from GMT and LT or LMT. For this example, let's consider India. From our early examples, if we consider different cities of India, you can see that they lie in different time zones. Some are in zone time 5, some are in 6, and a few in 7. But as we all know, India doesn't keep different time zones for different states or different part of the country. They keep one time zone across all of India, and that is GMT plus 5.5 or negative 5.5, however you may prefer. This is called as standard time. Despite the fact that the country is extending to different time zones, the government prefers to keep one standard time. This standard time may be corresponding to the time zone in which the country lies or may not be. Another example is Pakistan and Afghanistan. Although most part of Pakistan and all of Afghanistan lie in the same zone time, Afghanistan keeps negative 4.5 as their standard time and Pakistan keeps negative 5 as their standard time. So contradictory to all three above, that is GMT, LT and LMT, the standard time is at the sole decision of the government. But it's not far away from the zone time where that country lies on the map of the world. If they drift too far from the zone time, then all the sunrise and sunset will be completely screwed up. Another very interesting thing over here is the DST, or daylight saving time, that many countries use. In the northern spring season, the clocks are advanced by 1 hour, and in the northern autumn season, the clocks are retarded by 1 hour. This is done to take advantage of the sun rising early in the summer season. This gives 1 hour of extra daylight in the day, and it helps in reducing the electricity consumption during the summers. But not every country does that, and the exact dates on which the clocks are to be advanced or retarded, it depends from country to country. Usually, the Saturdays or Sundays are chosen to do so in order to have a minimal impact on the routine of the people. Now, let's talk about us, the ships. What are the timing important for us, and how do we manage all of those time changes? For us, two of the times are most important. First is UTC, or the Universal Time Coordinated, and the second is Standard Time of the countries. Now, you guys must be wondering, what is this UTC? And some people who know about the UTC might even be saying that, oh, Captain, it's the same time as GMT. Why would you mention it separately? No, dears, that is not true. For most part, the GMT and UTC are quite similar to each other, but the main building block of UTC and GMT are entirely different. GMT only consider changes of 1 hour every 15 degrees rotation of Earth or longitude. The UTC takes into account the actual rotation of Earth around the Sun, and while GMT considers 365 days as a year, UTC adds one leap second every 19 months to keep up. And UTC is the time standard that is used to coordinate all of the world, and all the clocks in the world are actually based or coordinated with the UTC. Although the time difference is small, maybe in seconds or milliseconds, but it's important. And that is the reason we actually consider only UTC when synchronizing our clocks. And then the standard time of every country is important to us, because obviously we would maintain the time of the country where we are arriving. Just about a day or a couple of days before arriving that country, we ensure that our clocks are at the same time as the clocks of the country or the port where we are arriving. But the most interesting things actually happen when we are at sea, as then we keep the time that is called as SMT, or the ship's mean time. In the beginning of the video, I told you guys that when we go east of Greenwich Meridian, the time is added for every degree of longitude that we move east, and it's subtracted for every degree of the longitude that we move west. Now, a ship is always or mostly in motion at sea. And it would be very, very silly if we keep on changing our clocks for every degree, every minute, or every second of the longitude. So naturally, that's not how we do it. I personally keep in view the daylight times. I mean, when the sun is rising and when the sun is going to set, so that we have the complete daylight available for everyone to work. And then we keep a check on which time zone we are in. We usually just see our longitude and calculate it ourselves. And the clocks are actually retarded or advanced by 1 hour, unless we are going to a country that has half an hour added or subtracted from the time zone. This advance or retard of the clocks is performed at midnight, so that every watchkeeper easily knows when he needs to adjust his timings. And naturally, the people are happy when the clocks are retarded. That means 1 hour of extra sleep for everyone, versus when the clocks are advanced, which means that they have to sleep 1 hour less on that night. And unlike you people on land, we don't have that luxury of advancing and retarding the clocks only on holidays. These changes are happening pretty much any time or any day it is required. For a newcomer on vessel, this might be a little too much to adjust to, but we, the seasoned mariners, are all well used to all of these changes of the clocks. And while we do feel happy or sad when the clocks are retarded or advanced, there is actually nothing we can do about it, except we have to embrace the change. The biggest shock or exciting thing, depending upon the people, is when we cross the dateline, which is close to and usually synonymous to the anti-meridian or 180 degrees of longitude, as at that time the vessel crosses the dateline, which means either one day will be completely disappearing from your life, or one day is added again and you get to relive the same day again. Usually when the ship crosses the dateline going eastwards, one day is reversed. Just for fun, we make an announcement on the ship telling everyone that now they have gone one day back in the past and now they have one more day to live. Most people at this point are happy. But when the ship crosses the dateline going westward, one day is gained and it is wiped off from everyone's life. That means one day is subtracted. And the people are usually excited at the fact that they didn't have to work for one day. Well, that's in theory, they actually have to. Now, this process of advancing and retarding clocks is performed very swiftly across the ships with just a few touches. All the watchkeeper needs to do is punch in how many minutes or seconds or even hours he wishes to adjust. And once this command is executed here, all the ship's clocks start advancing or retarding in harmony. So that was pretty much it for today's video. If you guys found this video useful or learned something from it, then don't forget to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and consider subscribing to my channel. With tons of love for my digital family and to be digital family, this is me, Zahid Nisar. You guys are watching Captain Zahid, and until the next video, bye.